This is the bold. I am the beautiful. And the third wonder is my closet. The bold and the beautiful.
As you can see, the variety is mesmerizing. And now I will try to play an expert and tell you the difference between a screw and a bolt. So, when you get the bolt and you want to assemble two unthreaded components together with the help of a nut, this is it. When you take a screw, that's a different story. A screw, for me, is almost the same, except for one thing. When you drive it in, it makes some self-unthreaded channeling into the device, although joining two components together. Historically, the screw is well known because it was invented by Arkitas 400 before Christ. Arkitas was contemporary of Plato, the founder of mechanics. So fantastic. And at the very beginning, it was used to press oils from olives and juice from grapes in presses. It was wooden. And another thing is that the gardens of Babylon had water drawn by devices in which screws were playing the best part, but they were wooden. Next came 15th century and screws became metal, and except for metal parts, they were handmade, so very unique and unrepeatable. So that's one of the difference. Now, if you think of the design, which until yesterday I thought was only going with shoes and cars, it also goes with screws and bolts. So here we have a head, a drive, a shank, a thread, and a tip. So taking them all together, it works fantastically.
The head can be countersank, raised, or round.
Then you've got here some kind of drive, and the drive is especially designed for a screwdriver bit. It's important if you don't want to make many mistakes. Then you've got a shank and a thread. And a thread starts just under the head and finishes at the tip, which for me is quite fascinating because the tip penetrates the material and the sharp one is for decking, which I didn't know, but might be useful. And here comes the big news. A thread on a screw forms a helix, not a spiral. Alright, so a purist may say that a spiral is a curve that winds around a fixed point with a continuously increasing radius. But a helix is the three-dimensional curve that twists around its cylinder at a constant inclined angle. Do you get that? I hope you do, because for me it's the magic, right? So remember, spiral staircases form helixes, not spirals. Maybe next time it comes useful. Mm-hmm. What makes them those little pretty beauty ones? What makes them so specific? Are many factors, but I'm going to enumerate just few of them. This is going to be the material, a resistant to corrosion, strength, sustainability, and ability to withstand low and high temperatures. If you're thinking of using one of them, I have a perfect tool for you. It doesn't require any knowledge, you just have to press. Or not. Yeah, you have to press, right? And you see here are screwdriver's bits that match each and every driver which is here. if you are lucky, like I am today, right? This is the first option. The second option, if you become lazy at some moment, is this one. Yeah. As you can see, our offer is huge. We have the small ones and the mid-sized ones in which we specialize. My personal favorites are those tiny ones, which I just completely enjoy. But do we have them all? Check our offer, visit our website, and enjoy the next episode.
We post and share our creative videos on YouTube. We successfully exist on Facebook, and we create our website presence here. So, make sure you subscribe.
Can you see the cats on their heads? You can see them, and I can name them. Philips, Positive, Hex, and Torx. I didn't. You can. So, if you find them attractive, and I'm sure you do, I would like you to join me in the next episode, and then I'm going to reveal extra knowledge about their source.